You are here this evening because you are a responsible citizen, a citizen concerned about Salem, its present and its future. I am Dr. Vern Miller, and I'm proud to serve as the mayor of Salem, a city of concerned and responsible citizens like you. In the next few minutes, you are going to hear about a problem, your problem, because it's Salem's problem, and you're going to be asked to make a decision which can provide the solution for Salem. At the conclusion of the program, you are urged to ask questions on specifics we may not have covered in this brief presentation. A representative of the Citizens Civic Buildings Committee is here to answer any and all of your questions so that you may have all the facts when you make your very important decision. But first, let me give you a little background on the problem. The physical needs for a new city hall are readily apparent to any citizen who will take the time to tour the present facility, built in 1893. Moreover, efficiency of our fire, police, and other governmental operations is impeded. In order to study the need, not only for these facilities, but a library as well, we appointed a citizens' committee composed of a cross-section of individuals living in various parts of the city and of different occupations, housewives and senior citizens, to go into the matter thoroughly. These people arrived at the conclusion that Salem needs new civic buildings. They studied a number of proposed locations and recommended two to be placed on the ballot at a special election. The committee's recommendation was brought before your city council, and on August 12, a special election was set for September 30th. As your mayor, I urge you to learn all you can about the need. I invite you to see City Hall for yourself. As your mayor, and speaking for the mayor and the City Council of Salem, you rightly hold us responsible for the proper administration of city government. We cannot in good conscience tell you we are at the present time very efficient, cramped as we are, and spread around the town as we are. Your city hall spells Salem to visitors. We can limp along and build later, but all the while building costs are going up and suitable property is disappearing. Or we can face reality now and put our house in order. I earnestly solicit your understanding of the need. Please give your full attention to the brief program we are about to present. At the end of the program, ask any questions you want answered. And if you want to learn more, visit City Hall, the police department, the fire department, and the library. If you do these things, I am sure you will come to the same conclusions as your fellow citizens on the Civic Study Committee, the decision that Salem does indeed need new buildings now.
Salem's venerable old City Hall was built in 1893, 75 years ago. In those 75 years, the city's population has multiplied nearly 14 times, from 5,000 to over 67,000. In those 75 years, the number of municipal departments and municipal employees needed to serve you, the people of Salem, has outgrown the fine old building, which was built to serve a city the size of Woodburn.
Today, the City Engineering Department is located across the river in West Salem. The offices of the City Planning Director are in the County Courthouse. The City Parks Department is 2 miles from City Hall. The Utilities Department is a quarter of a mile to the south. And other municipal departments are out on 22nd Street, south of Mission. And still, the City Hall is bursting at its seams. The cause is simple. More people need more service. More people need more police protection, more fire protection. And the government structure needed to serve a city of more people, 67,000 people, just can't do the job in a building built to serve a city of 5,000 people. The effect is a city planner's nightmare, a hodgepodge of municipal offices spread out all over Salem. The effect is felt by every person who lives in Salem, who has to pay a traffic fine, or return a library book, or order water service, or consult with the Parks Department, or seek a building permit or zoning variance. The effect is inefficiency and inconvenience.
And now, right now, is the time that the inconvenience and inefficient cause and effects can be eliminated. There is an answer for you and for Salem, but there's a decision to be made first. Since Salem is your city, that decision must be made by you. And since prime property is rapidly disappearing and building costs are accelerating at the same pace, that decision must be made now. On September 30th, you can make a decision which will give the people of Salem a civic center worthy of the capital of Oregon. Not a monument, but a functional, efficient center for you and your government. A committee of your fellow citizens, people from every walk of life, every residential area, of every adult age and economic level, have selected two possible sites for the new civic center. On September 30th, you can indicate on a preferential ballot which site you think would serve Salem best. Both sites border on the downtown area. One is north, one is south.
Most of you are already familiar with the south site. Called the Hillside site, it was included in the Package for Progress measures presented to Salem voters in 1966. Since that time, the architectural design and cost estimates for completion of a civic center on that site have been refined. The four-block Hillside site is south of the Marion Hotel. It is bordered on the north by Trade, on the south by Leslie, on the east by Liberty, and on the west by Commercial. Building plans for the south site have been carefully created around an inviting park-like setting containing the city hall, library, and fire station.
Use of native Oregon materials, stone, and brick will enhance the simple beauty of the civic center design. Ample public parking is provided for. The present plan will meet Salem's needs until at least 1985, and buildings are designed for expansion to meet future needs. The south site offers opportunity for an uninterrupted development and creation of an artificial lake with terraces through the use of Pringle Creek, which runs through the property. The site offers two layers of comparatively inexpensive parking under the city hall, which will be projected out over the hill, thus creating space under the building without elaborate excavation requirements. The south hillside site commands a sweeping view of the city. The civic center on this site could be seen from the heart of the city. It would become as meaningful and proud a Salem landmark as the beautiful and functional Capitol Mall.
The north site was selected this year by the Salem Citizens Committee too recently for preparation of architects' designs, too recently for detailed property and construction estimates. The site has been located in the northern area bounded by High, D, Winter, and Union Streets. If the voters favor this site, the exact location within the area boundaries would be chosen by the council with the advice of engineers, architects, and citizens of the committee. The north site has taken its name from the stream that runs through the area. It is called the Mill Creek site. Here, a dramatic architectural treatment would be possible.
Towering 50-year-old oak trees and the flowing stream could be woven into the total development plan. Buildings on the site could well utilize more vertical construction than is possible on the hillside site. The Mill Creek site could provide a connection with the ultimate expansion of the Capitol Mall, and the gently flowing mill stream sets a mood of serenity and dignity for a civic center in this park-like setting, comfortably surrounded by huge old shade trees. Although there is no architect's model for the Mill Creek site, outstanding civic centers have been built on similar flat land locations in nearby Oregon and Washington cities.
The Eugene Civic Center, for example, is an excellent design for a level site. Truly magnificent civic centers have been approved by the people and built in Eugene, Medford, Vancouver, and Olympia. The people in these four cities, with populations comparable to or smaller than Salem's, saw the need and filled it with outstanding civic buildings, buildings of lasting beauty and long-range usability. And now you have the opportunity to vote the same convenience, the same efficiency, the same prestige and beauty for your city. On either site, north or south, the proposed Civic Center would include a new city hall, central police facilities, a new public library, and a central fire station. We've already talked about the need for a new city hall, but what about the other facilities?
Your city police protect your home, your business, your streets, protect you, your family, and your neighbors. You probably don't think about the police until you need them. But when you need help, your city policeman is the best friend you can have. There are city policemen on the job 24 hours of every day. And to do that job right, they must depend on the finest equipment and the best communication system available. Like any other working man, your city policeman is entitled to a working environment where he has at least the basics. Good lighting, adequate restroom facilities, enough elbow room in which to work. But in Salem's present city hall, he doesn't even have the basics. Salem's recruit training program is outstanding. So outstanding that police departments from cities all over the valley regularly ask to send representatives to the sessions. But there just isn't enough space available to accommodate these requests. There isn't even enough space available for Salem recruits.
In Salem's overcrowded city hall, there simply isn't room for a modern and complete communications facility. Did you know that if you start a new business, you cannot install a burglar alarm system connecting with the police department? A standard procedure available in cities throughout the country, cities much smaller than Salem. This type of alarm system is basic to the security of any business. But City Hall electronic equipment for such systems has been used up. There just isn't room for any more, so new businesses are out of luck.
The new Civic Center would provide your police with a much-needed communication systems to fully service all the businesses and all of the people of Salem. It would provide better and faster protection for your home, your business, your life. Today, the police do the very best they can within the framework of existing facilities. That they do so well is a tribute to the talents and energies of the department. And of course, the police are not the only city servants with an acute communications problem.
Equally critical are the needs of the fire department. Fire alarm systems, like burglar alarm systems, aren't available to anyone anymore. The quota has been used up. The present fire alarm communication system is heavily overloaded, and there's just no room at the firehouse. Communications isn't the only serious problem at the fire station. The building is too small to house a much-needed new snorkel truck. So Salem must do without one of these new 85-foot ladder trucks, essential to better fire protection. The need for this equipment cannot be minimized. For example, with a snorkel truck, the fire department could undoubtedly have saved the Keith Brown Lumber Company and Marth IGA store. But there's just no room at the firehouse.
This lack of room could cost you considerable money, not only in property loss, but in expensive fire insurance premiums, premiums that come out of your budget to protect your property. The space crisis at the fire station is a very real threat to the ratings given by the American Insurance Association. And the lower the rating, the lower your personal fire insurance premiums.
There's a space crisis at the public library, too. Salem's public library was built in 1912 to serve 12,000 people. Today, 56 years and some 55,000 people later, the same library tries to serve the city of Salem. And as the students in your family can tell you, the library has long since run out. Run out of shelf space, run out of adequate reading and research facilities, run out of room for children's programs, run out of any potential to adequately serve the reading needs of a city of over 67,000 people. The library has run out of room outside, too, as anyone who's ever tried to get a parking place near there knows. The new library will have plenty of parking space, will have a meeting room, a facility long overdue for Salem citizens, a facility which will be available to all the people, to all groups for visiting lecturers, slideshows, for movies, for meetings. The new library will be a place for many worthwhile programs for all of Salem's population, from the very young through to the senior citizens. And it will be designed to serve you, your children, and your children's children for many years to come.
A library, a fire station, a police department, and a city hall. These are the four basic components of your new Civic Center. Each will be designed to meet the needs of Salem citizens today and tomorrow. Included in your Civic Center will be an ample public parking area, an easy-to-reach drive-through window for the Salemite on the go who wants to conduct his business without leaving his car, a spacious council chamber, an art gallery, and a large open plaza. The entire Civic Center complex will be set in a lovely park area. It will be designed to meet the needs of our city government, and it will be designed to give Salem an outstandingly beautiful city building complex. A city the size of Salem need not take a backseat to the cities the size of Eugene, Vancouver, Olympia, or Medford, not in aesthetic values, not in efficient government services. You'll be proud of your new Civic Center, and even more important, you'll be secure in the knowledge that your public servants are public servants housed in working quarters and departments that allow them to realize the full potential of their abilities and to give you the very finest professional service.
Probably there isn't a citizen in Salem who doesn't want to be proud of his city, who doesn't recognize the need for better public buildings, for better public services. Probably there isn't a citizen in Salem who wouldn't like to see the dream of this truly beautiful and functional Civic Center a reality. But just as probably, there isn't a citizen in Salem who isn't concerned about the cost of a new Civic Center, the cost in terms of his monthly earnings. So let's talk about the hardcore dollars and cents price of a new Civic Center for Salem. In total dollars, it's a lot of money, $6 million. And there's only one way to raise that $6 million, as any civics student knows. On September 30th, you will be asked to approve a Civic Center bond issue and thereby raise your city taxes 2 4/10 mils.
Perhaps you don't realize that in the past 2 years, your city taxes have been lowered by 2 4/10 mils. So the actual tax levy will put your city taxes at exactly the same level they were at in 1966. That means it is now possible, and probably because of climbing costs of building and property, it will never be possible again, for you to solve the Salem public buildings problem without paying any more city tax than the millage you have already paid.
Here's how it works when translated into dollars and cents. If you own an $8,000 home, it will cost you 45 cents a month to build a new Civic Center. If you own a $12,000 home, your city tax increase will be 60 cents a month. And if you own a $20,000 home, you will pay $1 a month more in city tax so that your city can have a new Civic Center. Let's look at the medium or average figure again. 60 cents a month. Think about it in terms of value received for money spent. 60 cents a month. Not very much, is it? It's less than the cost of a lunch. It's less than the cost of a babysitter for half an evening. It's less than the cost of 2 gallons of gas. For 60 cents a month, just pennies a day, you can give your city efficiency, beauty. You can give your city a civic center to serve the needs of today and meet the challenge of tomorrow. For 60 cents a month, you can give your city the civic center it so desperately needs. Even a year from now, this won't be possible because costs are going up, not down. This is a bigger bargain at less cost today than will ever again be available.
The Salem Civic Center is long overdue. Salem can no longer afford the inefficiencies and inadequacies of its present public buildings. You can no longer afford these inadequacies either. The time is now. The decision is yours. On September 30th, vote yes for the Salem Civic Center.
Your yes vote is an investment in tomorrow. It is an investment in your city's future, in your children's future. It is an average 60 cents monthly investment with an immediate $6 million return and a return far beyond that cost. a priceless return for all the years to come. Vote yes on September 30th.